If I want to change how a material looks in 3D views, I can use the Adjust Material Definition tool to change it throughout my entire plan, or on individual objects within the plan. In order to use the Adjust Material Definition tool, you must first be in a camera view. This tool is not available in plan views. Once in camera view, I can go to the 3D menu, Adjust Materials, and click on the Adjust Material Definition option. Then, I can click on any material I can see in the 3D view to modify it. If I click on this floor material, it will bring up the material definition dialog, and I can adjust it to fit the needs of my project. For example, if I wanted to change the angle of my flooring, I'll click on the angle box and change the angle to 90 degrees and click OK. Now the angle of the flooring throughout my entire plan has rotated 90 degrees. I can also use the Adjust Material Definition tool to completely customize an existing material to fit my needs. For example, I want a black and white checkered pattern tile in this bathroom. I have a black and white diamond tile pattern in here currently. I can modify this to become the material I want to use. I'll select my Adjust Material Definition tool from my toolbar, and then click on the tile to adjust it. I'll change the angle of the material from 45 degrees to 0 degrees to straighten it out. I'll also change the tile size from 4x4 to 12x12. This will give me the look I'm going for in my bathroom. I know that I may use a material like this in the future, so I want to add this to my library. While I'm still here in the Define Material dialog, I can click on this Add to Library button to add it to my user catalog. This way, I can use this material in the future in other plans. Once I've added this to my user library, I'll click OK to see my changes applied to the bathroom. When working in a plan, Chief Architect identifies different materials by their unique names. As you've noticed throughout this video, after I make a change to a material, anywhere else it's used in the plan updates to match the changes. If I want to change the definition of a material on just one object or group of objects, I need to create a copy of the material that uses a unique name. To do this, I can use the Adjust Material Definition tool and change the scope the tool affects. You can change the scope down on the Edit toolbar once you select the Adjust Material Definition tool. By default, you'll be in Plan mode, which means the changes made to a material will affect every other instance of the material in the entire plan. This is how we've worked up to this point. There are several different modes you can use that will change how the new material will be used in the plan. The C is for Component mode. This will apply the adjusted material to just that individual component on that one object. O is for Object mode. This will apply the material changes to just this one object and no other objects in the plan. R is for Room mode. This will behave the same way as Object mode, except it will apply the new material to all similar objects with the similar material in the room containing the object you clicked on. F is for Floor mode. This will behave the same way as Object mode, except it will apply the new material to all similar objects with a similar material on the floor containing the object you clicked on. If I change the scope to anything other than the entire plan, when I click on a material, Chief will prompt me to create a copy of the material and to give it a unique name. In this case, I want to modify the material on this custom countertop in the kitchen island without modifying the countertops of the rest of the cabinets. So, I will select my Adjust Material Definition tool and change the scope to Object mode. Then I will click on the island countertop. This window that comes up is Chief asking for a unique name for this material. I will name it White Gold No Repeat and click OK. In the Material Definition window, I will go to the Texture panel and check the Stretch to Fit checkbox. This will make it so the texture does not repeat but will stretch out to cover the entire surface of the countertop. Once I've made this change, I'll go ahead and click OK, and notice how the material changed on the island countertop, but not the other countertops in the kitchen. Using the Adjust Material Definition tool, it's possible to customize almost any material to match the needs of your plan and apply those changes throughout the entire plan or just in certain areas.